Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This healing day. This healing. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This beautiful day. This beautiful day. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. My wonderful friends. Thank you. I'm so grateful. Thank you. I'm so grateful. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day, this healing day.
Need a couple minutes.
Beautiful ginger coil. Thank you. If this looks strange to you, ginger has stepped up and come in for us. We are sending radiant health to Beth Naur. And ginger stepped up and beautiful expression for us today. So I want to start with our opening prayer.
It's not 10.
Go ahead. So welcome. So if you will repeat after me, I open my heart to the universe, accepting love and peace. I open my heart to the universe, accepting love and joy. I open my heart to the universe, accepting infinite help. So welcome. We're so glad you're here. We've got a wonderful service for you today. Obviously, we've got the wonderful ginger coil here. We've got practitioners around the Zoom holding the high watch, knowing the truth for all of us. So let's forget about the day, the past, and be present right here, right now. Let go of any doubts, limitations, fears, and just center ourselves in this service so that we can open up to the divine and remember all of the wonderful things that we live. Remember all of the truths that we are. We've got a wonderful team of Zoom practitioners. We've got Kathy Miller doing second practitioner, who is getting the prayers together. So if you have prayers, send them into the office. Kathy will get them and disseminate them to all the practitioners. So you got a team of people on your prayers. So we've got Jane Hobson behind the scenes doing all the Zoom stuff for us. So thank you. I am third practitioner and associate minister today. And we have the wonderful Catherine McClellan running this service and leading this service. And we got the amazing Kathy Milano doing our meditation. So we've got a wonderful service for you here. So I want to bring up our first practitioner, Hashi Shreffler, to do our invocation.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you, Reverend Paul. So let us come together and in prayer and intention and setting the energetic stage for this, the rest of our day, the rest of our lives. Join me in prayer, closing our eyes and taking this breath together. Knowing that it is the power of the divine, of this one life that breathes us in this eternal now moment that we've come together in sacred community. And knowing that it is this life that is the source of all good that animates in such beautiful and wonderful ways in this gathering of minds and hearts and bodies across time and space. And so giving thanks for this sacred community called the Center for Conscious Living, where we get to show up and remember that we are living consciousness, that we are human beings, divine expressions of this one life. We get to be reminded of the glory of the divine that is living and breathing and expressing through each one of us in such miraculous ways. And that just showing up, that this presence of each one here is the gift that keeps giving as spirit unfolds so beautifully in our lives together in this moment. And so I give thanks for this service. I give thanks for Reverend Catherine and Reverend Paul holding the high watch for us and leading this beautiful congregation. I give thanks for the joy of music as it shows through and flows through Ginger Coil. I give thanks for each one that chose to be here today to add their presence into this vibratory collective that radiates out into this world. And I give thanks for the abundance that is the Center of Conscious Living. Knowing that this abundance radiates and fills each one of our lives in ways that we can't even imagine and touches each life that we touch into eternity. And so knowing that this moment is the beginning of the rest of our lives, I give thanks for the divine gift that is this one life breathing us. And so releasing this word, knowing that it is done and it is so good because it's all God, I say, and so it is.
Ginger, we're not being able to hear you right now. Ginger, can you hear me?
Can't hear you.
We can't.
I'm sorry. I was using my button on my mic. That did not work.
No, that's okay.
Let's try that again. I said it was a beautiful invocation, Aji.
Words are flowing out like rain into a paper cup. They slither wildly as they make their way across the universe. dance before me like a million eyes. They call me on and on across the universe. Thoughts meander like a restless wind inside a letterbox. They tumble blindly as they make their way across the undying love, which shines around me like a million suns and calls me on and on across the universe. Jai Guru Deva Om. Nothing's gonna change.
Was so beautiful. Thank you, Ginger. So I have the delight of reading the inspirational reading this morning, and it is from Spiritual Liberation by Dr. Michael Bernard Beckwith. And I'm reading an embodiment, page 64. And I invite you to close your eyes if that feels good. In this moment of quietude, this moment of devotion, this moment of resolve, I surrender. I let go of all that would inhibit my realization of my oneness with the spirit. I allow myself to feel that I'm living, moving, and having my being in the divine presence. It's everywhere. It's everywhere, being itself. I now allow it to express in and through me, to be me, the real me. I now arise from the mist of illusion and release all obstructions to a realization of my wholeness, my completeness. I release anything that would hinder, block, delay, or obstruct the divine from flowing through and as me right now, just as electricity is invisible unless it's shining through a light bulb. God is everywhere now, becoming visible through my hands and feet, through my generosity, forgiveness, and love. It is in this awareness that I throw myself wide open and become available to the Spirit of God, the Spirit of life, the Spirit of love to transform my consciousness. I speak this word knowing that my life is a dynamic emanation of my source. It is so activated within me that something wonderful is taking place, something magnificent, something joy-filled, something peaceful, something resurrecting, something jubilant, something victorious is happening right now. The strongholds of negativity are crystal and crystallized thought and habit patterns that have emerged from my ego's sense of separation have no more power over me. They are being dissolved right now, requalified, redeemed. I am no longer subject to the tyranny of trends. It has no power over my discernment, my clarity. I am a full participant in divine order. The body of my affairs now take on that shape. There is a fundamental order and harmony that now takes over my life. It doesn't need my help. It needs my permission to come through. It needs me to let it be. As a spiritual warrior, I welcome divine order and confidently move into whatever is required to become my authentic self. This is the me of me I yearn to know and express. A freedom song sings through me now. It's a song of infinite potential and divine possibility. I am in league with pure spirit in the conscious co-creation of my life and body of affairs. I am a distribution center of generosity, joy, love, forgiveness, and beauty. I was born free and now enter the depths of my soul to discover my ultimate freedom. It is done. Thank you.
Thank you for that. Beautiful. Every moment of this service is a moment of choice, of surrender into that beautiful wholeness. And so now we're going to do our affirmations together. And I haven't spoken to you yet this morning, so I am saying good morning and welcome and sending my love and care to all who are serving and all who are here in service of receiving, that we all are doing both in all moments. So together we say this affirmation. I'll say them first. We'll do them as call and response. So I love it when everyone unmutes. So if you can stand the chaos, join the chaos. It's right behind this great reading that Aji brought us from Reverend Michael Beckwith this morning. I am the love that indwells all being. I am the light that shines through all things.
I am the light that shines through all things.
I am the peace that touches all things.
I am the peace that touches all things.
I am the grace that blesses all things.
I am the grace that blesses all things.
And so it is.
So it is.
And so it is.
So let's chant together. The mantra is Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. We can all do that. Thank you.
introduce. So it is absolutely my pleasure to have Kathy Milano here. She is just such a wonderful support to our community. She's just an amazing consciousness. I'm so excited to have her here, and she's just an amazing presence. So welcome, Kathy. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you, everyone. It's such a beautiful prayer. Michael Beckwith, thank you, Haji, and the music. So we've had this invitation to surrender deeply to that which is within, and with the chant of Ganesha to remove that, all of that that's in the way of what wants to emerge. So I invite us to place hand on hand just for a moment and begin to breathe within your heart and to deepen into this coherence. As you drop into the breath and the beauty of holding your own heart, you recognize that your body is already breathing you perfectly. Paying attention now, you see how it wants to breathe in this very moment. You can trust the wisdom of your own beautiful energy and this breath of life. And flipping your hands one more time, what is it like to gently place your hand again upon your heart? And how does the breath of life rise and fall in this holy moment, inviting you to receive and then give it away? And gently, with tender care, you switch one last time, recognizing the mystery that is present, for the breath is breathing you, and you are breathing life. You are not the doer and yet the expressor of this magnificence of living. This is a call to participate in what is already moving through you, wherever you are, whatever arrives on your doorstep, whatever invites you out to play, and whatever you carry with you to bring to meet this invitation. Life, the mystery, the source that is behind and beneath and within all things, is the doer. And you are the great participant, the player. And trusting the wisdom of your own precious body, your being, your soul, your capacity to translate this invitation. You take one more breath and wonder, what is life inviting me to explore in this very moment? And you may relax into the invitation that is deeply personal and goes beyond you, broadcasting to all beings. There is a knock on your own door, the door of your heart, the door of your wise essence. And there is an invitation to wake the love of God, that which has been hidden from you, buried in the closets of your history, your innocent ignorance. This invitation is so powerful, it blows these doors open, gently or with force, to invite the waking of good, the presence of love. And this is not inviting that which you know, for that which you know and express already knows how to step through this door out into the world, to reach for others, to receive from others. And this holy invitation to wake the love of the goddess, to invoke the love that is so pure, to take that which is invisible, ineffable, and make it known, felt, so that as you move, it glides through you, embracing you and pulling you towards that which requires it. And now the day becomes interesting, for as you walk and drive, as you talk and work, you find that all that which is seeking love appears before you. Drivers that are angry, shopkeepers that are rude, bosses that are harried and demanding, children that are whiny and requiring attention, stomachs that rumble for food, and those that cower away from the violence of the world, the violence in their homes, the violence in their minds. And you breathe with a focus on the exhale out through the mouth, for love escapes through every pore and every breath. Love is the great doer. And you, as the dancer, need only watch what steps you are being invited to mimic. And the body is wise, and the soul, well, the soul is enthusiastic. You find a rhythm when you respond to the invitation to wake the love of God. You find a rhythm within your being that moves your body, that takes your face and turns it towards that which you need to see and hear. And then it holds you if that is difficult to be present to. It holds you in the swaying embrace of love, opening these doors within you. So that you may witness suffering and yet not suffer. You may dance with the energy of love, knowing that your hands, your movements, your statements, your gaze will be perfect in that moment, whether accepted or rejected. And yet, as one who wakes the love of God and dances to this rhythm, you are asked, invited even, to step further out of the circles in which you move, to recognize that love is unboundaried, and so it may truly unbind you. It requires that you leave the home that you built, to venture into the neighborhoods that are foreign to you, with the people who think differently than you, who live from different places of mind, culture, songs, acceptance and rejections. You, the curious one, are merely following the doer, which is love. But to see how love operates and to serve as that rhythm of love, to truly wake the goddess, to wake the god, to wake that ineffable presence, you must step out of the spaces of comfort. Perhaps you are within a family, a neighborhood, a workplace that at times thinks quite differently from you, perceives a different reality, and in fact lives within a different reality. And you discover when love pulls you that you have erected boundaries there in order to hold some oxygen until you return to your people, your tribe, your like-minded individual and communities. And yet love laughs as she pulls you, saying, "Watch me breathe." And love breathes in what you see as density, small-mindedness, harsh beliefs and actions. Love breathes in the mindless broadcast of news and media and television, of the ignorance of judging one who is different than another, those outside the religion, the neighborhood, the skin color, the belief systems, the culture. Love invites you instead to wake the commonality of its presence, to come within to those you see as unlike-minded, and to watch them pet their animals, kiss their wives, breathe the air, listen to the bird song, sing the praises of a religion that seems so restrictive to you, and yet devotion is in movement and love is delighted, not divided. There can be no unification across the universe if the doors are closed within you to the waking of love in its broadest form. When you listen to the myths and stories of those that are different to you, whether they are the family stories of delight or despair, of justice and revenge, of harm and help, or whether they are between people, neighborhoods, parties, countries, religions. Across all borders, what you will find is that love dances And if you seek only the like-minded across the globe and throughout the universe, you will be disturbed in the dividedness. Love as your guide and the great doer delights in the shadow. For in the shadow, in the darkest places of shame and despair, of hopelessness and helplessness, of hatred and violence, well, love sings a song that has the capacity to open the doors gently or abruptly, so that in a moment, the light pierces the shadow and there is potential. Chosen or rejected, it matters not to this great doer, this perfect dancer. And what you notice is that in responding to this invitation to wake the love of God within, to step out of your home with its closed doors, to leave the comforts of your known places, that you travel deep within the shadow lands of your own being to discover all peoples that are different from you reside within you. And you recognize that as you step in form as a body, voice, smile, gazer, listener, hand reaching, arm hugging person, you find that those who you previously saw as separate reflect to you these places within you that are magnificent, pride-worthy, that are despicable and shame-inducing. And now love delights with a jig of gratitude, for other doors have opened within you to see that the healing of this cosmic web is within the power of the dancer. That waking the love of God or the goddess, waking the love of whatever is prayed to, as restrictive or expansive as that idea is, all ideas dissipate as doors open, and simply love dances with itself. In tune, out of tune, awkwardly, and with great fluidity. And there is a recognition that all brothers, all sisters, all siblings, all of the parents, fluid in nature, all of the ancestors, those that come in the future, ancestors yet to become in form, those that emerge in different realities beyond your current seeing, the butterflies, the mountains, the stars, and the fire deep within the center of the earth, all siblings. And we look to see that the stars that shine brightly and bring delight are known as that which is dead. And yet, energy, light, love, inspiration is breathed into every particle in form. And stardust is living, waving in the wind as trees, running through the neighborhood as children. moving through the oceans, polluting the earth. To wake the love of self is to wake the love of the world, is to wake the love of the cosmic energy, harmonizing, recognizing that the doer is a perfect dancer. And the knock that is upon the door of your own mind, it is the wisdom in your body. It is the calling of your own soul. It is the strong impulse to open the doors within you. And if you are afraid of the dark or ashamed of what is hidden deep within your being, the shame inherited by ancestors that you do not know about things that you have no knowledge, embedded shame. To recognize that love exists and dance within that shame, that darkness, that fear, and your body, which is wise, and your breath, which is inspired, and your mind, even, despite its limits, agree. Let us wake the love of God within. Let us wake the love of Goddess within. Let us wake the love by every description within. Noticing that it matters not whether it is within me or within you. Within, let it awaken, and yet you, embodied, have a vessel that seems physical and is energetic, that is always moving and interconnected with all vessels, all movements. This is the place to begin. Inspired. Breathing in the invitation and letting it go to every place within you that has not yet heard the call to wake to love. Be not concerned with outcome. Be not enamored with the discovery of places within that have answered the call, for there are more places within that have not heard it yet or have locked and barred the doors and windows. Let go of outcome. Breathe in the invitation and let go of outcome. And leave your neighborhood. Seek the other. Be curious to witness where love lies in shadow and light. It is through the informational movement that you may be informed of the places within you that wish to awaken to love. And without concern for outcome, yet with the courage and conviction and curiosity of one determined to know love. It will awaken across the universe. This is the peacekeeping, the way showing, the unifying movement, not only in the divided states of America, but in the lack of unification within you, your friends, your family, your workplace, your society, within the legal system, the educational system, all governmental systems, all systems that seek control through division and the sowing of fear, that harvest greed enacted with violence. These are safe places to wander. When you listen to the call to awaken to love, guided by the wisdom of your body and your soul and the breath. This invitation has been received for a moment. Be curious how it has landed within you.
Thank you, Kathy. Thank you for these words, this beautiful space for us to invite our next steps into loving. Ginger will take us into
I am.
Yuki. I know there is but one mind, which is the mind of God. In which all people live and move and have their being. I know there is a divine pattern for humanity, and within
seems we've lost sound.
Let's see if it's specific to Soul Sanctuary.
Hearing you, Kathy.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Catherine, how about you?
I can hear you.
I can't hear you.
Can anybody who can hear me, raise your hand. Maybe we're back. We are having something in the field, this powerful meditation that Kathy just let us on. Maybe messing with our system. So. Can everyone hear me still? Okay. Did you hear the prayer for peace? No. Let's try it again. Okay. It's a prayer of world peace by Ernest Holmes. And if you can't find the words, I enabled the transcript at the bottom of the screen. You should be able to see that. And we're going to continue. I know there is but one mind, which is the mind of God, in which all people live and move and have their being. I know there is a divine pattern for humanity. Within this pattern, there is infinite harmony and peace, cooperation, unity, and mutual helpfulness. I know that the mind of humankind, being one with the mind of God, shall discover the method, the way, and the means best fitted to permit the flow of divine love between individuals and nations. Thus harmony, peace and cooperation, unity and mutual helpfulness are experienced by all. I know there will be a free interchange of ideas, cultures, and spiritual concepts, of ethics, of educational systems, and good scientific discoveries. For all good belongs to all alike.
There's no sound.
Ask if they can hear you now.
Can you hear me now?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
My apologies, I got kicked off and I have no idea where we're at.
She's up.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay, and we're all having a problem.
Okay.
It's not just you.
Yeah. All right. I am so blessed, or the offertory?
Not quite yet.
Okay, just let me know.
We're at Ho'oponopono.
Gotcha. Thank you.
I can't hear anything at all because I have a headset on, so you have to take yours off. Where's your sound?
Right there.
Can't hear anything. Where's your volume?
I don't know. I don't love this computer.
We can hear you.
Oh, you're good.
Okay, good. There we go. Now there we go. There we go. Okay. So sorry about all that technical difficulty thing. In this moment, this is the time of our offering. And so we just take this moment to revel in the beauty of this service and know that the beauty of this service is unfolding exactly in the mind of God, exactly the way it is supposed to. And all of these people that we are so touched by are sharing and loving and bringing their beautiful and glorious selves into this space. And all of this greatness, all of this giving, all of this loving, all of this joy is supported and held by all of us and all of you. And so right here and now, we invite your blessings for this congregation, for this service, for this church, for this time, for this space, as we say the blessing of our offering together. Thank you, God, for this abundance that is mine to share. I bless this gift and give it to thee in gratitude and joy, knowing that as I give, I do receive. And now, Ginger, if you would join us with I am so blessed.
So we are getting things together on the fly, and everything is in divine right order, is what we always know. And there is a gift in here somewhere, and we'll find it. So thank you for being with us. Sure, you don't want to do the blessing?
Yeah.
Do it?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. We're coordinating here. I think we've got it.
Here we are. Thank you so much for.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Do this. Try that.
Thank you for your patience today as we sort through this. We love you. We bless you. And as you can see, we are really working this organization of ourselves this morning. So what I would like to do is share with you at this point in the service that our first practitioner is really someone whom we love and adore and who gives us so many beautiful gifts as a community, as in friendship, in love, and in many other ways. And today we wanted to share with you, if you have not read your bulletin this week, we ask you to go back and find the June 1st, the first one of the week, where we talked about Haji and all the beautiful things that she does with and for us. And now I just want to share a few of the specifics of that so you can know. So she's been, Haji, you have been a member of our community for 14 years. And in that time, you have been a blessing to all. You have been an involved and active member, and you have been a humanitarian presence for all of us. We're just taking breaths between breaths so all of us can actually allow this to come in so we can see you and experience you as you are to this community and show you as you are to all of us. So Haji completed her practitioner training in 2013, and she's been involved in all things CCL since then. Your service, Haji, is deeply appreciated. Deeply appreciated as you step in wherever you are needed. You have assisted in Sunday services, both as practitioner, as you're doing today, and also as setup, running around and helping us put things in the right place and getting everything in order for others. She has served, you have served on several teams and committees, and presently you are serving for us so powerfully on our BIPOC, in our BIPOC circle, as you have named it, and also in our stewardship committee with so much time and energy and love. And we do so deeply appreciate this. We would be remiss if we did not mention that in 2011, you went to Haiti for the first humanitarian visit and got interested in being an active part of caring for the children. And from there grew Love Orphanage, your passion and project that you have brought to CCL and have invited us all to be part of. Thank you for spreading our wings beyond the borders of our own country. And as Kathy said, so eloquently this morning, into places where we might not normally go. Thank you for inviting us there and for making a difference there. You have built us and grown us stronger and more full in your presence and in your vision. Bless you. And today, we want you to know just so very deeply, and we want this congregation to know who you have been and who you are being. And thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We bless you, we receive you, and we gift you again with our love. And so now we are moving into our announcements portion of our service. And just so you all know, I'm working on two computers here, so I don't know if you can tell that or not, but we're having some fun. And we are getting the work done. So here we are. And if all has gone well, the announcements are sitting right here on my desktop. But for now, I'm going to tell you what they are. So the first invitation is that I am still soliciting and really deliciously receiving many of you one-on-one And I would like to continue to carry that process. I'll be going back to California this week, but please know that my heart is now bicoastal. And even if my body is one place or the other, I am still available. I'm about to establish some office hours, so it's going to be predictable when you can reach me, probably for the health and well-being of all of us. In the meantime, please just keep reaching out to the office and asking for connection. I am so grateful to be connected to each and every one of you. From your roses, to your heartbeats, to the things you love, to kindness, to care, to all the things that we're beginning to share together. Let us let that grow and love Orphanage too. The other announcements are that our board of directors, of course, that includes me, are so grateful to all, each and every one of you for every gift. I am so impacted this morning by how many people here today are the gift givers of this organization in every way. And that is a powerful, powerful statement about who we are and what we love. And we are also inviting you to please go back and read the announcements in both Wednesday and Saturday newsletters and bulletins this week, because there's a lot of announcements in there that I can't possibly remember right now, and I'm not having them at my fingertips. One is, please remember to bring your plastic bags to church, because that is so fun. And we're only trying to grab some 100 pounds of plastic bags. And I think it's 500. Marty, you can chime in if you can find your way to that.
That's exactly right. Thank you. We're partway there. We have over 100 pounds collected already.
That's fantastic. Great to know. So remember, bring your plastic bags and give them all to Marty, and he'll figure out what to do with them next. Holly Myers is standing in a kindness project, which is fantastic. And you can read about, and you'll read about again next Tuesday in our newsletter. So please go back and find those things so you can find the dates and times and reach out to these beautiful people if they need your support or what they need or how you can contribute or be part of these things. Also, there is a concert happening on July 10th that is a community event through Jackie. And that also is in there. And I know there are some other things that I should be telling you. So for now, please know that the ones that came to the top were the ones that I have probably spoken, people I've spoken to this week most immediately. And know that your announcement is as close to my heart as it can be. And please, everyone, just go check other places for those things. I just want to honor so much the value and the work and the support and the service of everyone who is here today. Your contribution is important. Bless you, bless you, bless you. And so, Ginger Coyle, it is you.
Okay. Let's sing the peace song like we always do.
Let it begin with me.
Beautiful, Ginger. If everybody will take a nice, deep, deep breath, relaxing into this moment right here, right now, giving gratitude for this beautiful service, being grateful for this life that we live and love, being grateful for the divine presence that guides us through every moment. Gratitude for this wonderful service, this coming together of this congregation and this one mind, this one heart. Being grateful for the music, for the beautiful, beautiful meditation, which we can bask in and guide us through this week. Knowing that we are the beloved of the beloved, that we are completely guided, completely supported, and we give thanks for this support and love. We give thanks for this community, this entity, this consciousness that is the Center for Conscious Living. We give thanks for all the congregation, all of us, for it takes a village, and we are all here in love and in joy and in peace. And we are all here in this consciousness, in this gratitude, in this joy. And in this gratitude and joy, knowing that we are completely taken care of, we say, and so it is. And now I'd like to bring up Haji Schreffler to do our concluding affirmation.
Yes. Oh, what a glorious day. So if you will say with me in the chat, it's posted. So something wonderful is happening to me right now.
Something wonderful is happening to me right now.
It is this thing called life. Life is in my body.
Life is in my mind. Life is in my feelings.
Life is in all my activities.
I receive it.
I share it. I am it. And I accept it. Just the way that it is. Thank you, life. And accepting all of these amazing gifts, we say
yes. Beautiful.
Good job.
Thank you all.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Kathy.
Thank you, everyone.
Great meditation, Kathy.
Ginger, brilliant.
Beautiful. Thank you for your music and for stepping in.
Thank you for your consciousness and your love.
Thank you, Robin.
Thank you for your service, Haji.
Yes, thank you, Haji.
Thank you.
You are the rose in our midst.
Oh, beautiful.
In my garden.
Beautiful.
Go to gallery.
Love you all.
Thank you for everyone who came to the Rose Show yesterday.
Oh.
Yeah, a lot of CCL people there.
Good. Nice.
Good.
Beautiful, Rose.
Have a wonderful week.
Everybody, have a great week.
Happy day.
Bye.
Happy day. All. Enjoy this one. It's beautiful.
Yep.
Thank you, Paul.
Love you.
Thank you, everyone.
Big
hugs
to all.
More than
welcome.
Thanks, Linda.
Thank you for your postcards. Oh, lovely.
What is that?
There's two Junes.
Oh, there we go.
Ah.
Oh, that's Holly. Thank you.
Hi, Cassandra.
Hi.
Hi, Peggy.
Hi. Thank you.
Beautiful Rose.
Thanks, Holly.
Hello, everybody. Thank
you. Love you, Linda.
Love.
Thank you.
Love to you all. Have a great week.
How was Moosetown Day, Holly?
Outstanding.
Yeah. One day I'll get there.
I'm working on a post. Moosetown?
Nice.
Oh, good. Okay.
Nice.
Okay.
Yeah.
Funny transcriptions. What's most count?
I think the transcriptions are hysterical.
They're hilarious.
It's like the transcription Zoom is translating our inner thoughts.
There you go. There you go.
Oh dear, I wonder what.
Yeah, really. Well, yeah.
Bye, bye, everybody. See you soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Love you guys.
Everybody. Oops, I got to turn it the other way.